Today I'm going to work on my cattle trailer a little bit. This has made an appearance in several other videos. In case you haven't seen it, just to recap, I bought this last year on an online auction for practically nothing because it had a broken axle. And I fixed the axle and I've used it a little bit since then, but I need to use it a little more this fall now. So I've decided that I want to, I'm going to take the other axle out. The front axle is the one that I rebuilt. I'm going to take the back axle out and look at it and make sure it's sound, and if it needs it, maybe reinforce it a little bit. So I need to do that just so I feel a little bit better about using it. This is the only cattle trailer I have now. Of course, I sold my Super Duty and the 20-foot gooseneck cattle trailer, aluminum trailer that we used to have, that actually belonged to my former business partner that was around here, is gone. It's sold now. So of course I don't use a cattle trailer nearly as much as years ago, back when we were milking cows here and had about 100 head of cattle around. I've just got a fraction of that now, and this will suit my needs just fine. I have been doing a little other work on it. I've where the basically the frame of the trailer is good, the top of the trailer is good. The problem is where the top meets the frame, the lighter box steel has gotten kind of rusty. Right there, it was broke loose, and I welded a piece of heavy angle iron out there. I just look up here, I see that's a pretty impressive looking spider up there. I might have to think I will get rid of him before I do a lot of work on here. But anyway, so yeah, I'm going to pull the back axle out from under this thing, and while I've got the axle out, before I put it back in, I'm also going to put some new brakes on that axle. I got these complete backing plate assemblies. Got these on the interwebs. They weren't too bad. They're only 35 bucks a piece. That's pretty reasonable. And I plan on pulling the trailer mostly with my 76 F-150 here. And I just put a new electric trailer brake controller in this. It hadn't had one before, and I didn't bother to pull the one out of the Super Duty before I sold it. So I'll get the brakes on this and we'll see how it works. If I still don't think it's quite enough, maybe I can always put new brakes on the front axle, have brakes on both axles. But I'll get this going and try it first and see how that works. So I guess I'll get busy taking this thing apart now. All right, we've got the axle out. I've got it here apart, and it's kind of scaly in here, but basically pretty solid. The part that I found that I'm kind of concerned about, I think you can see it, it shows up here. We got the tall spots here where the U-clamps were, and it has corroded down on either side of where the U-bolt was there. So that's concerning, because you know the middle part of the axle isn't really where most of the stress is. Most of the stress on this is from the spring hanger on out to the spindle. So so yeah, this, where this is corroded off, these parts are not as strong as it used to be. Now these axles are pretty thick, but looking around my scrap pile, I see I do have part of the other axle left sitting here. So I think what I am going to do, I'm going to cut a piece of that, maybe about 6 to 8 inches long, then slice it diagonally and put it, lay it on top of here, weld it to the spindle here and along here, and essentially double the thickness of that. That should add enough strength on there that it should be all right. So that's the plan. Okay, I think this is going to work. I've got my piece of the old axle all cut out and cleaned up. But as you can see, it's fairly thick there. Sorry for the wind, it's kind of breezy here today, but it looks like it's about maybe it used to be 1/4 inch, looks like it's probably 3/16 now, but I've got it cleaned up and I'm going to clamp that in place and get it welded on. Alright, I've got both sides reinforced. Not the prettiest beads I've ever run, but they will hold, and I'm pretty confident in this thing now. I'll throw this back underneath the trailer, and I think I won't have to worry about it so much. So we'll go ahead and throw this back underneath the trailer now and bolt the backing plates on. Okay, I've got the axle bolted back in. And the new brake assembly is bolted on. In case anyone out there doesn't know how electric trailer brakes work, this piece right here is a magnet, an electric magnet. And when you apply 12 volts to that, it magnetizes it and it wants to stick to this surface of the brake drum. And the movement of the wheel, the brake drum, engages the brakes. So the drums on this thing don't look too bad. They're lots of meat on them, but they're a little bit rusty, so I need to next thing I need to do now is attack those with my big ass wire brush. Alright, I've got the drums cleaned off and installed. I've got the brakes adjusted up, and I've got the tires and wheels installed, and I've got the trailer sitting back on the ground. I do not have the new brakes wired up yet, but my body is telling me that I've had enough fun for one day. Anyway, I'm pretty satisfied with what I did get done today. I can use the trailer now and not worry so much about breaking another axle, so that's a good thing. So all in all, not bad. So that's it for this project today. I'm going to go in the house, have dinner and relax. So until next time, have a good day.